And Jeeps, I taught for long enough, you know, a long time. And one of the things all teachers learn in that is where do you get your ideas from? You get them from colleagues, you get them from other schools, you get them from the moments when your experience touches another's experience, and above all else, you get them from learning with and talking to the students about what works for them. This doesn't mean that the students are going to lead you by the nose, but that learner voice is a key part of what works. We've got schools all around the world that are looking at new models of learning, and some pretty remarkable things. There are schools out there that are closing their staff rooms, that the children share the space with the, you know, we've got schools that are doing 1 month long timetable blocks. You do a whole subject in 1 month and move on. All these schools that are trying new ideas are all doing it for one reason: things got better. So as a teacher, you know, faced with an agile space, which is a blank sheet of paper, you know, how might I teach in that space is actually much easier than you think. First of all, talk to other people who've been in spaces like it, who are a year or 2 years or 3 years or 4 years down the path. You know, secondly, you have to do this as a team. You can't have three people turn up in a space and all teach the lesson that they used to teach. It isn't going to work, you know, any more than you'd have three people who'd learned to ride a horse. You put them in a car and expect one of them to be able to drive. You know, it's a new world, it's a new thing. But dialogue is absolutely key to all this. Alleluia, you know, we're not in a world anymore where teachers are told what to do and expected to adhere identically to it. We're in a world where teachers are expected to use their professional judgment on doing it better. And doing it better means not doing it differently, but it means being asked, not being told. And the key thing here is to discover what works, but talk to others. You know, we can't. The world actually is full of great ingredients for learning. They're all out there. You know, people have tried everything. I've stolen from Scandinavia shoes off schools. I love the kids taking their shoes off when they come in. Turns out when they take their shoes off, their testosterone is in their shoes. The boys, you know, they just behave different with their shoes off. I don't know why, you know, but it works. So you know, reach out to other places, other colleagues. Borrow their ingredients and build a great local recipe. Your school is full of unique children, unique staff, in unique circumstances, in a unique context, and a unique culture. You know, nothing out there will identically work for you. But the challenge is, what is your local recipe going to be? All I'm saying is, you know, use the ingredients that are tested and tried in 21st century schools, and build yourself a new local recipe. And then share it with others, and then keep the menu fresh. You know, you don't say, right, we've got that fixed now, we'll do that for the next 20 years. You know, tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow, you're going to keep changing. And that professionalism is why we all came into this, isn't it? I think so. I did.